I'd just like to start by saying thanks very much for coming out here. Sounds, by the way, that Melissa was talking that if this is a smart thing to come in, you know, it's obviously sorted out. This is how it's going to carry on, and that's awesome for the BMW. If they can do more of these things and get bigger and better as they keep growing, then it's just more training for everybody else, which obviously results in safer and more well informed. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about using online resources to expand your planning knowledge. Just a quick bit of background on myself. So I'm a certified artist, contract planner. I trained and worked in the UK. I've worked in Australia, and now I live and work in Canada. I run a couple of industry websites. The nearest one is planningartistjobs.com, which is basically just a job platform specific to the art industry. And more relevant to the talk is planningartist.com, which I run. It's a free resource aimed at professional artists, artists that are just getting into the industry, that kind of thing. There's a video library in there, full of different things, not tying and climbing. Loads of videos on tree climbing competitions. We just started a blog on there as well, because there's some really good information on there. We started talking about to guests. Bloggers. The latest one was done by Kevin Bean, the inventor of the rope wrench. And it's a really interesting read, so if you haven't read that yet, I'd encourage you to go and have a read. It's just it's a real safety-orientated topic, so it's a really good one. Before we get into looking at using online training, I really want to point out first that the risks that it involves, because it's basically down to yourself to go and to judge what's good quality information and what's bad. It's quite easy distinction between good and bad. There's some really awesome stuff out there, but there's probably just about as much terrible stuff out there. But then it's the stuff in the middle that is the stuff that can kind of catch people out. It's people filming videos good, but then it's full of bad habits, especially like Brian mentioned at the end of his talk, tying in twice when you're using a chainsaw and using a chainsaw one-handed. Those kind of things really can sneak in there, especially for the new artist, the new kind of climber that's really starting to learn. If people have a huge following on, say, YouTube or it can be quite easy. Get sucked into thinking, oh yeah, that's got a lot of views, they must know what they're talking about. So it's, at the end of the day, you're the person that is making a decision whether the information is right or not, and you're going to use it. So you just got to err on the side of caution for quite a lot of stuff. So why do we look to online as well as physical training? Well, if you look at if you look at universities and colleges, there's a lot of art courses going on there that cover a lot of art water culture, and they'll always tack on tree climbing as part of it, but tree climbing is aimed at the basics, because they're teaching people that haven't really done it before. So once you've got past the basics, the training kind of dries up. Then it gets a little bit more sporadic after that. There's equipment suppliers that will put on talks here and there. There's some good training outfits, but it's not common. There's no structure to people putting on these talks. It's kind of they do it when and where it can suit them, and they can fill up the courses. It's very sporadic. So that's why we turn to the internet, because the internet seems to be the only way that we can get information from our peers and from other people that's going to keep up with the equipment that's coming out, because the industry is evolving at such a fast rate. Climbing techniques, people are coming out with ideas week in, week out, and the internet's the only way to really keep up with the evolution of the equipment. So the first one I'll touch on is using YouTube. YouTube is obviously the biggest video platform out there online, so it's the place where everybody seems to upload videos. So YouTube's a great one if you can, you can pretty much type in anything and you'll be able to find a video on any subject. So tree climbing is no different, and as long as you can kind of start following and subscribing to certain channels and like reputable channels that you know, and see what's going on their channels, following other people, and soon you'll build up a good portfolio. You'll receive notifications when new videos come out, so you can just keep up to date. So obviously YouTube is a huge one. Facebook, since Facebook launched their group, like the Facebook groups, it has become a hugely popular, especially in our industry, that people can have conversations, they can report new equipment, come up with new ideas. I've put on the slide here a few of the groups that I'm part of and contribute to sometimes. These are the ones that I found really useful. I mean, there's so many more, but I'd say these are kind of the main ones that I've come across. And the thing with Facebook, everybody's using Facebook 6-7 times a day or whatever. So if you're unsure of something and you're asking questions, you can get instant responses from tens of people. you can get responses from all sorts of people. But Facebook, because people want it all day long, some people can start leaving that. That's where I come on to using forums. Forums is, I haven't used forums in a while, but I used to use RP, mainly because it's a UK-based forum, so because I live in the UK, I used to use that all the time. Forums are awesome because they're well-structured, they're categorized into different things. You can go on there and find something from 2007, 2006 or something, just as easily as like the present stuff, whereas using Facebook, nobody ever really trawls through the past 2 days. Using forums is a really good thing. And the thing you'll find in there, you get a better quality of response. People, rather than it taking a couple of seconds to sign on, a lot of forums maybe takes 15, so it kind of weeds out a lot of people. Like forums, it's the people that really want to help people, and rather than just criticising what you do or criticising the questions that you ask on forums, they'll give you like advice and ways in which to help, and just little kind of constructive criticism. So I really encourage, if you haven't been on some of the tree climbing forums, and that's a really good place to start and to kind of conversate with people. Also, another one that you may not think of, but tree equipment suppliers have some really good information. They have, like Tree Tools has a really good blog. It's a New Zealand-based tree equipment supplier. They have a really good blog about all kinds of different information, and they keep you up to date with safety alerts and safety recalls and that kind of thing. Cheryl has quite a good learning centre on there that they do all videos just to help you run through equipment maintenance and inspections and that kind of thing. But also have a blog, so that's something that you may not think of, but the equipment suppliers contribute. And then a shameless plug for my own website. The reason I created this climbingarbis.com was to kind of bring all that information and try and put it in one place so that people can find videos on all different kinds of different kinds of tree climbing techniques. Like I said before, we just started a blog, so there's some really good information coming out of that. And just useful links and trying to build a bit of a community for people to reach out and ask questions and that kind of thing. So, as I put here, it's stupid not to use the internet to learn. It's kind of taken on, like I say, it can keep up with the industry. Like, that's the biggest thing. The industry is progressing at such a fast rate. Where I've used books, when I first got into the industry, that we still learn for the first kind of 6-7 years. Now it kind of seems like maybe that wouldn't happen. Because if you were to publish a book, it'd take a few years to get that through the works. And then by the time it comes to publish, all those techniques are kind of just old and seem basic compared to the new stuff that's coming out. So
definitely use internet as one source of your training, but do take caution, and there's a few key factors here. Use many different sites. Use common sense, it's the biggest one. Use common sense when, like Will was saying, don't go out and buy the latest thing because you've seen somebody else and then buy them a good phone. Use common sense with what you're seeing, and if you think there's something in it, if you don't just think, oh, well, he's doing it, so it must be good. Share the information that you learn with your fellow professionals. That's what it's all about, networking and sharing with your peers and sharing with your new green guys that are learning on the ground and that are really interesting. Nobody knows everything. All the panelists today, we don't know everything about everything. So ask questions. Don't be embarrassed to ask questions, even if it might sound silly to you. Go ahead and ask them. That's how we learn. So yeah, use the internet to make useful contacts. Well, like Facebook is a great one for making contacts. You might talk in groups with people for a couple of years and then maybe go to a planning competition and meet them face to face. And all kinds of things can come out of that. So last key point is nobody else is responsible for the information that you take in apart from yourself. So even though somebody puts out a video, like, they're not responsible for what you do with that information. Like, it might be absolute crap that they're talking, but they're not responsible for what you do with it. And in our industry, in our job, that information can be life-threatening. Like, if you take on board some information that somebody's given you that's going to be crap, then